Philadelphia fans love their teams and are some of the most passionate fans in the world, but they also once pelted Santa Claus with snowballs at an Eagles game. And so it's fair to say that sometimes the passion goes a little far. Well, we knew that when Ben Simmons requested a trade that eventually the Philly locals would have something to say, and boy have they. Slandering the All-Star with an absolutely brutal dumpster dig, we got all that and more. So stay tuned. The Ben Simmons drama escalates again. It feels like whenever the Ben Simmons drama has reached its peak, it finds a way to get even worse. 2 years ago, when the Sixers were underperforming, it was all about how Joel Embiid and Simmons didn't fit well together, and that one had to go. Last year, Ben Simmons infamously passed up an easy dunk with their season on the line against the Hawks, something that even his coaches and teammates couldn't defend him for. That inevitably led to him submitting his trade demand this offseason. Things even seemed quiet for a while, with Embiid throwing in some half-hearted endorsements of his soon-to-be former teammates, and many doing that part to keep this whole circus show civil, at least publicly. You just knew that the Philly fans couldn't keep it bottled up forever, though. Ben Simmons is garbage? Is Ben Simmons garbage? It's hard to say that any consecutive All-Star could be, but that didn't stop Fox 29 Philadelphia from making that accusation on their broadcast recently. The news anchor says that he has footage of Ben Simmons fleeing Philly, and then shows a garbage bin being carried by water and a brutal burn that had the sports reporter on scene for the segment absolutely shocked. While it is pretty funny from a neutral point of view, the whole ordeal is seen by some as proof about what Joel Embiid said about Philly fans earlier this offseason. Joel Embiid chimes in. Joel Embiid has never been one to shy away from the spotlight, and is one of the funniest players in the league with his antics and social media presence. That's why many took to his tweet saying that Philly fans need to be better as an honest plea to help not only their perception to their fan bases, but also to free agents that may steer clear of the harsh and critical supporters. The whole Ben Simmons situation has been tough, but ultimately Ben has kept his mouth shut for the most part, and maybe it's time that Philly follows suit. What's next in Philly? Besides Ben getting out of there as soon as possible, unfortunately, it doesn't seem that teams are willing to bail out GM Daryl Morey and take Ben Simmons off his hands. But at some point, someone inevitably will want to take on the young star, Simmons, and see if a change of scenery is all he needs. It doesn't seem like there's a chance that Ben stays, and many believe that management and the fans have given up on the player they once thought would lead them to a championship. So, will Ben Simmons suit up for the Sixers this season? I would say yes. James Harden tried to force his way out of Houston last season, and ultimately succeeded, but not until suiting up and playing some games for the Rockets first before the Nets finally came calling. Ben, by all accounts, isn't the same caliber player as James Harden, so I could see things taking longer to unfold, especially since the 76ers need a good return on investment to stay competitive, unlike the Rockets, who are all in on the rebuild. Expect things to get uglier by the day in Philly. So, who could pick him up? Right now, it seems that the Timberwolves are the team most interested in Ben Simmons, but it doesn't seem like they have or are willing to give up enough to get him. The problem with Ben is that he's probably more of a floor raiser than a ceiling raiser, or in other words, he makes you good, but not good enough to be a championship piece. This makes trades much harder, because as we mentioned earlier, the Sixers are not interested in a rebuild. Expect bottom feeder teams to make offers at Ben, but ultimately, it's possible that a trade won't materialize until another star grows unhappy somewhere else. Perhaps Damian Lillard over in Portland. He seems to have his own drama circling him this season as well. Marc Gasol returns to the Grizzlies. I personally think that this whole situation worked out extremely well for both parties. Marc gets to return to Memphis, a city that loves him and where he spent the prime of his career. Marc Gasol gets to have his fairy book ending if he chooses to, since he's still unsure about returning to the US from Spain while the pandemic continues, while the Lakers get his contract off the books. LA didn't really need Gasol this season, not only because he fell out of the rotation last year, but also because with Dwight Howard returning after a short stint in Philly and DeAndre Jordan signing after being bought out of his contract, it doesn't really seem like there's much room for the Spaniard and his methodical player. This trade is the rare win-win, where both parties walk away happy with the result. The NBA's own Field of Dreams. The MLB knocked it out of the park this season by building an official ballpark park across from where the Field of Dreams film was shot. The movie is a classic, and seeing it brought to life down to the same Yankees and White Sox wearing the same uniforms that they did in the movie was awesome to see, and so it only makes sense that other sports would try and get a slice of the action themselves. The NBA, according to reports, is thinking about doing their own version of the event, holding NBA games in non-traditional locations. The NBA doesn't seem to be interested in recreating a movie, though, and instead wants to take basketball games where they have always been played, outside. Iconic venue Rucker Park in New York immediately comes to mind, as does the Santa Monica Boardwalk in LA. The tricky part of the whole thing is going to be figuring out where to put fans, but as long as they can figure that out, the sky is the limit. I, for one, am excited to see more sports create interesting spectacles, much like the NBA did years ago with special jerseys for Christmas. There's something about the events that make it feel important, even when it's just a regular season matchup. I can't wait to see what the league comes up with. NBA 2K22 wows fans and critics alike. The only person harder to please than NBA fans are NBA 2K fans, as they know exactly what they want the game to look like and feel like. Fans and critics were very impressed with 2K this year, though, as the game refined its My Career mode, added depth to coaches in My GM, and much, much more. In an era where games like Madden and NFL's flagship video game franchise receive some of the lowest user reviews of any game ever, it's nice to see the NBA's video game nail it, as everybody wins when fans are able to get immersed in the world of professional basketball and experience the world through players' eyes. This news came as a sigh of relief for many, as last year's game frustrated many fans, and so, for the folks down at 2K to listen to fans and improve the game speaks volumes to their respect for the community. Fans make huge bets on the Nets. An NBA fan made a $20,000 bet that the Brooklyn Nets would win the NBA championship this season, potentially netting them $48,000 if they end up going all the way. The Nets took the eventual champ Milwaukee Bucks to the wire last season, losing in OT in Game 7. That was without Kyrie Irving or a healthy James Harden, though, and so many experts expect the Nets to go even farther this year. Still, injury concerns have to be weighed on the better, as literally anything can happen across the course of a season, as we saw last year with tons of injuries, upsets, and general weirdness last season. All I can say is good luck, whoever you are. Rasheed Wallace speaks, angers everyone. Rasheed Wallace has never been one for subtlety. It showed in the record amount of technical fouls he gathered throughout his tremendous NBA career. Recent comments that he made about LeBron James then rubbed many the wrong way, as Sheed implied that LeBron would have held his own, but not been anything special if he played in an earlier era. This straw man's argument always rubs fans the wrong way, as players frequently cite the difficulty of the era, whatever it may be, to bash the accomplishments of modern-day players. It isn't a very interesting argument because it's all opinions, with no proof or insight to back it up. I think we would all be better off admitting that each era had its own challenges to overcome instead of trying to put down the present and future of the league. Judging from Twitter, it seems most of you guys agree with me. And that about wraps up the video. Thanks for watching.